Hello, today we're starting our new booklet, Quadratic Equations. It has a picture of an equation down here. Okay, the first section is called Factoring Monomials. Okay, so we already talked about what monomials are in the last unit. And now factoring is a way of breaking things apart. So it's a way of breaking numbers and variables, which, as we talked about, that's basically a monomial, down into separate pieces. And just to kind of visualize it, just want you to play with me here for a minute. This is similar to separating Legos. I don't know if any of you guys have played with Legos. My kids used to love to play with Legos when they were younger. And I still enjoy actually putting together stuff sometimes when they have sets and things. So when you separate Legos, you can only break them down so far, right? Unless you're going to use a hacksaw or something and break it apart. But essentially, you make these amazing creations, and then you can break them into little pieces. But there's only so many. You can only break it down so far, because once you get to the pieces, that's the basic piece. And so when you find the prime factorization, you break the monomial into the smallest pieces possible. So this would be like breaking it into just tiny Lego pieces. And there's a certain way, some are bigger, some are smaller, but there's a certain way that they break apart. And a factor tree can help you factor the number part. The exponent tells you how the variable can be factored. Okay, so you probably remember this from way back when. So basically, when you do a factor tree, you're just kind of dividing things into what they can multiply by, so but into factors. So you just think about two things that multiply together to get 20, any two numbers. So the first one that came to mind for me is 4 times 5, and then 2 times 2 is 4. When we get to the end of the factor tree, sometimes you circle them like that. Those are the important factors, and the prime factorization are those things multiplied together. So for instance, we have a 2 here, we have another 2. It's important to keep all of those in there. And we also have a 5. If you multiply those three numbers together, you get 20. So 2 times 2 is 4, 4 times 5 is 20. And then the x, because it's x squared, that means I have two x's multiplied together like that. So we have 2 times 2 times 5 times x times x. And that would be the prime factorization, like those breaking it into all the smallest pieces possible. Okay, so let's look at this one. So there should be enough space on here to just go ahead and factor it underneath like that. And then that is 5 times 5, and we've got 3 x's, so x, x, x. Okay, 12 is 4 times 3. And 4 is also 2 times 2. You may say, well, 3 is also 1 times 3, but you don't actually write that, because when you multiply by 1, it doesn't actually change anything, and 1 is not included as one of the prime factors. So 2 times 2 times 3. And we've got two y's multiplied together. Okay, next, 24. So you might start with 8 times 3, or you might start with 6 times 4. Either way, when you get to the end, that's when all the pieces are the same. So if you'd started with, just as a side note, if you had started with 8 times 3, notice you'd then have 2 times 4, 2 times 2. Do you see how the factors are actually the same? 2, 2, 2, and 3. It just means that you are breaking them in a slightly different order, but in the end, it has to come down to there's only one way to factor it. So we've got 2 times 2 times 2 times 3, and we have just one x there. Okay, 18 is 2 times 9, 3 times 3. And I might write it down here, there's not a lot of space up there. So we have got 2, and as a general rule, it's best to put them in smallest to largest order. So 2 times 3 times 3, x, x, y, y, y. All right, next we have 3 times 10. 10 is 2 times 5. I think that is as far as we can go with that. So we've got 2 times 3 times 5, x, 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 whoops, didn't mean to put a y there, x, 3 x's, and 1 y. Alright, 21 is 3 times 7, and that's it. So 3 times 7, x, x. Alright, those are the smallest pieces. Talk to you guys later. Bye.